the video right here. Yeah, most definitely, Biggs. This game is one of those games where you can definitely end up with 100 hours, no problem. Especially if you do a lot of the side quests. Keeps you real busy. But anywho, this is Chapter 3. This is where we get to Listalem, doing a lot of the side stuff and different things like that. This is where we get to the chapter in which we get Equalizer Food, which makes it so that we get damage increase based on the double differences between us and whatever we're fighting. So if we're fighting something that is 50 levels above us, that's a 49 level difference. It applies into how the equation works out, and we do more damage because of it. The funny thing is, I actually was doing more damage than my first initial playthrough with the Equalizer Food buff on our allies. I do believe we're going to have to purchase the food one time for 7,000 gil, and then after that we can craft it for half the price at each individual camp.
The prince.
And we're just going to skip through all this. We're going to head instantly to the Chochibo area. We got to go ahead and kill the behemoth and all the other kind of stuff.
We
but we might get the
leave
food
this
for
dust behind.
I think we will.
Lands beyond are vast by comparison to lead.
Bigger's better. More stuff to see and do.
First comes to Sky, a region known for its wetlands.
Really? Wetlands?
There's also a Chocobo forest.
Now we're talking!
Further west lies the Klain region, wherein we'll find the town of Listalem.
Oh, isn't that where Iris is headed?
Barring delays, she should have arrived by now. Maybe even had herself a look at the meteor.
The meteor of the Six?
The same. Its heat is harnessed to power Listalem.
Sounds way cool.
I'm actually looking forward to this.
It'll be a long drive. Best fill up the tank before we set out. I believe we have a solid lay of the land now.
There's some basic items you can pick up around here that's real easy to get. We're gonna head directly to the Chochibo Forest. Or actually, I think we might go to Listalem first. Just so we can get that food made. It makes a big difference and really speeds up the playthrough for the rest of the game, so. For some reason, I can't fill up the tank. Okay, I guess I need to get a phone call first.
Hello? Iris?
It's really you. Everything's fine, we just...
Yeah.
You better.
Cool.
Was that Iris?
So
what
there
about
we go,
me?
We can skip through all the storyline.
Did you see that sign?
Yeah, Chochibos, Chochibos.
No time for that. Need to get to Listalem.
It's still ages away.
Sometimes
come
like this,
on,
wish
just
I
a quick visit.
That. The unnecessary dialogue is a little bit draining sometimes.
First things first, Listalem.
All right, but next time we check out the Chocobos.
Okay, cool. So why don't I fill up our tank? So the tank is good, and we're gonna pick up some like little side items around here, and then we're gonna keep it moving onward and not at waste any times. The base coins are pretty good in the sense that you could sell them and get your money, because you're not gonna use them since it's a level 1 run through. The base coins and some of the other coins make it so you get more experience after a fight.
Welcome to the Crow's
Nest. Which is pointless
next.
In a level 1 playthrough.
What's on your minds?
Okay. So he's gonna reveal to us the local areas and the campsite.
We'll see you around.
Better make tracks. Ignis, we're going.
On my way.
I don't think I'm going crazy. Yeah, there it is. Every item you pick up is one you don't have to buy. Even though it doesn't make that too much of a difference. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and head over to Listalem. That's the next area.
Wanna come shopping
then
with
after
guy?
Listalem,
yeah,
we're going to
sure.
immediately go deal with the Chochibos. So we're going to go ahead and do auto, quest location, and Lestalem.
Everything in order.
Yeah, especially it's on sale right now for $40. Somebody just asked me to stream, is the game worth the price? Yes. Is it worth buying the cons for? Yes. I think it's overall a very good game. If it wasn't a Final Fantasy game, I'd give it a 9. If you hard compare it to other Final Fantasies, I'd give it about 7.5. But yeah, it's worth it, especially since it's on sale for $40 now as opposed to $60. Because after holiday times, they're going to crank that bad boy back up.
Infamous disc. Hey, Noct, don't you want to get a shot of you in the meteor?
Not now.
Not right now. Oh, come on. If not now, when? So Nox, I've been taking pics of whatever catches my eye, but what do you want to see?
What does it matter? Not my camera.
Yeah.
Enjoy the soundtrack. I just hate when Prompto asks the stupidest of questions. If I had a DLC to shut up Prompto, I would totally pay for it.
Titan's hands don't burn up.
Wait, I thought that was just a fairy tale.
Tales of the Six fighting alongside Lucian Kings date back to the Age of Gods.
For real?
For real.
And yet somehow I find it hard to believe.
Not all kings are created equal.
Yeah, laugh it up.
Hey, what's up, Broomgun? Happy holidays. We're doing the level 1 challenge walkthrough for Final Fantasy 15. We just finished chapters 1 and 2. We're now in chapter 3, which is the biggest prep level prep. We prepped a lot in chapter 1, 2.
Like
we just kind of sped
to
through
another dimension.
3. We also did as well, too. There's going to be a lot of prep in here. Well, I guess it would be safer to say after
wow.
The Titan fight,
nice.
We'll prep a good amount
there. This place
there.
Is pretty big.
We'll
haven't enjoyed the city life in a while.
They even got a cable car!
I'd like to see where it leads.
Okay, so this is the Stalin. We got a lot of stuff to get situated and figured out, but it's a pretty straightforward town. This is like, I have to say, this would be like the central hub of everything in the game. The major town you get shit done in. So we
it's
are
getting
here.
Getting hot out here.
Just need to pull in somewhere cool.
Yeah.
Any chance of sleeping in a nice room tonight?
Yes,
oh, you don't have to grind 99 to kill the turtle, you just gotta prep the right weapons. If somebody did a level 1 playthrough and they beat Adamantoise, it just took a decent amount of time.
They've got cup noodles outside the city. Alright.
Might be worth investing in a few servings. One hell of a crowd. Oh, this must be the main thoroughfare.
She's at the Laville. Let's go.
Okay. So there is an easy item right here, another rusted bit right here. Or I'm sorry, glass gemstone. My bad. I do believe it's used to upgrade one of the weapons we have. I forget which one. Okay, so here comes the interesting part. I might be able to craft the food right now, but I'm not too for sure. I'm gonna have to look up in terms of it for the recipe. We'll just head over here real quick. Talk
hey
to the
there.
Vendor.
Have yourself a good browse.
Midgar Solemn.
Pleasure doing business.
And then it's the nutmeg.
There's always more whenever you need it.
And let me see here. There's one more item, which is a killer tomato, which we can get from the vendor over here. I don't know if Ignis is high enough to cook it yet, but that's going to be pretty instrumental in what we're looking for. But we're just buying one of each, so we'll be able to make one of the foods, and then we're going to purchase
think
one of the food
think
items.
Falstar.
So where's the last one? Killer tomato. We need one of these.
Thanks. Bye now.
Cool.
That's it.
There it is.
What's up, Iggy?
That's the recipe.
Come up with a new recipe.
Can't wait to try it.
Seems the big tourism drive.
So, we got the, if we go here, what we just crafted in the archives is one of the most important foods for this run. So we'll go to dishes. And it's a higher level food item. Let me see here. Not that one. Well, I guess it hasn't showed up yet, because we'll have to either eat the food first and get the recipe, but we're going to go over, knock out this initial quest. Eventually, it's going to send us to go to a dungeon waterfall, or dungeon that behind there is a waterfall. But before we go do that, we're going to knock out some side quests and stuff like that, farm up a little, get our magic up, and then basically raffle stomp through the rest of the game.
Whoa! You feel that?
Holding your own out there.
What can I say? You look good.
All things considered, you guys are staying here, right?
That's the plan.
When you have time, we have catching up to do.
Sure.
Jared and Talcott. Is it good to...
Morning, sleepyhead.
Morning. Where is everyone?
Oh, they're out walking with Talcott. They went to see the sights. We should too.
Sure. Why not?
Great. I'll show you around.
It seems your patience was rewarding. Enjoy your walk, and please...
For our first stop, we'll check out the marketplace. Follow me, right this way. This is the Partella Market. You can get almost anything here. Isn't it great? I'd buy out the whole place if I could.
All these shops seem right up your alley.
You know me so well. Wow. Look at all this neat stuff. I'm gonna take a look. Give me just a sec. Done. Next, we're gonna see the power plant. That's the power plant. The driving force behind Lestalem's prosperity. But get this. Only women will... there. As a matter of fact, women are the ones who do all the work in this town.
Sounds like your kind of place. I can see you doing well here.
I think so too. It's so different from home. I was surprised at first, but I like it. All right. Next, we're going to the Outlook. I'm a city girl, but I dig the rustic charm.
Where's the food guy? I guess I can't talk to him while we're on a date. I was gonna peep out the local area. But we're gonna knock this quest out. It doesn't take too much.
You would totally love the drinks in this place.
Would I?
Pegler Outlook. Amazing view, right? Look, there's the meteor. Imagine taking one for Nacht. This almost feels like a date.
Oh, yeah. If it were, your brother would kick my ass.
We better keep it quiet then. And besides, you already have Lady Lunafreya. The others are probably back at the hotel by now.
Okay.
Let's join them.
So we're gonna return there. We'll get both food posts and get them to actually open up the area. We'll probably spend one night at the inn to get it to the next day, eat the food so we can go ahead and kill Bahamut and do some of the local stuff for the Chochubo quest and hit up some of the camps down there. Possibly do some of the hunts and
let's
keep it
moving.
Let's
see if the others are back. Haven't had fun like this since we were kids. Thanks, Nacht.
It's hard work babysitting. Better bring the fellas next time.
What do you mean, babysitting? Talk about ungrateful. Anyway, the thing I bought today, it's for you. But it's a surprise, so you're gonna have to wait.
Hey, look who's back. Talcott.
How you doing today, Scoob? Oh, we're just doing a level one walk.
You got it.
Oh, come now. Show some respect.
Whoa, no need to respect me.
This is going to be the next upcoming dungeon or the area we got to head to. We're not going to head there just yet. We're going to knock out some of the side quest stuff before we worry about doing Titan and all that good stuff.
Check it out.
Sure. Thanks for the tip, Talcott.
Okay. So now that's done. What we're going to do is we're actually going to go ahead and rest at this hotel real quick just to make time go by so we start in the morning because we don't want to get fuck up and get too much into the dark.
Will you be staying with us?
Then we're going to exit here, buy the very expensive food for 7,000, which gives us basically the buff that makes us so that every level between us and the monster gives us more damage. It's called Equalizer Food, which is very important for running through the level 1 quest. Or running through the rest of the game at only level 1, but not making it so that the fights take forever. So, let's go ahead and knock that out. Plus, once we get this food here, we can go kill Behemoth and it'll work out pretty well. If we have enough time, we might be able to fast travel back and actually start the events of the next dungeon. But we will see. One potion there. So the guy who actually sells the equalizer food is over here.
Welcome, welcome! Remind me, what was it you liked again?
And he shows us all the different camping spots, which works out pretty well. Alright. Now we're gonna go ahead and get the food. 7,200 gil. We're going to go ahead and eat it. Spicy skewers. And this is going to dramatically make the game very straightforward to beat out. Knock just learned the recipe, so we're good to go. I guess you have to buy it first. I thought I'd be able to cheat out 7,200 gil, so I didn't have to do that. But at least he knows it, and it's one Midgar soul and one nutmeg, one killer tomato, which we already bought, so we're good to go. So, we're going to go to the map, we're going to go ahead and go back to return the car, and we're going to go ahead and knock out that Behemoth quest. And then if we have enough time, and we do have a lot of extra magic, we might even just knock out the next dungeon as well, too. And then we'll figure it out from there. But one thing we are going to do before we leave is we're going to talk to this buddy right here. We're going to knock out all his quests up until the point of him sending us up to the Volcanic Mountain, because it's going to give us a shit ton of money. That will make our lives a lot easier because we're going to use that to craft the food that makes it so we get the huge damage and magic buff to roll through this level 1 playthrough for the rest of the game. He won't provide us all the money, but he'll give us, doing like the first 3 to 4 quests, I think it's just 3 or maybe before, gives you enough amount of money to keep things going in the right way. So, what we're going to do is go to map point. We're going to fast travel back here, then we're going to drive down to the Chochobo area, knock out the Behemoth quest because we got to get that done, and maybe and then head back to Lestalem, then drive out to the quest place if the food still lasts. I don't know. I don't think it will. I think we'll crap out before that, but that's okay. It's not the end of the world. So we're going to kill Behemoth. We're going to do some hunts. Everything possible until that food buff runs out, because that food buff is very expensive and we don't want to waste it, so we can get a lot of stuff done.
We need to replenish our supply of curatives.
Gotcha.
Which we don't, because I got plenty of curatives. So now we're just going to go ahead and hop right back in the car. Auto. Not quest location. Map point. And down here. Still early in the day. It's only 8 a.m. So we should be able to get a lot done. And like I said, this will set us up so that for the rest of the game, we don't have to worry about coming back farming unless you really want to. Okay, so we're in the area with the shelter clothes. We want to knock out this quest because if you don't have this quest done later on, there's a segment where you're supposed to use chochables to get around, and let me tell you, you do not want to fucking run during that segment. You can, but I would not advise it. Plus, the behemoth provides us a behemoth form. There's a lot of bristles that can be used for craftables, and it also get a good amount of gear reward for killing the behemoth. And then we do have our equalizer food buff on, so we don't want to waste that. One thing I will do is I will go to the Ascension Tree. We'll go ahead and go to Exploration. We'll go ahead and go down here. We're going to go ahead and take this one, which boosts the foods eaten at camp, even though it's now that we got officially got the recipe. And then basically, you can get this for 99 that further extends it, but the first boost is more than enough.
This is what I'm talking about.
The kids got it bad.
There it was. You want weapons?
And I think we're pretty good. We got the airship shore, the attack at 83. I don't think we need that blade of Brunei. I do think we need to pick up this.
Pleasure doing
business. Also, mythical lance. We don't need cutlass. We will pick up. And then we will get the calamity, but we're 300 gills short. So what we're going to do is go ahead and go to our items here. We're going to go ahead and sell the glass gemstone.
Pleasure doing business.
3 to base coins, electric condenser, rusted bit, iron shavings, beetle shells, 2 hardened hoofs, 2 hairy horns, 3 mesmer horns, and then what we're also going to go is go to accessories. We're selling bronze bangles, fencer anklet, garment bracelet, amethyst, oop! Sorry, Amethyst bracelet and carbon bangle. We're gonna pick up the last item for our boy here. We're also gonna go ahead and pick up the kite shield for Gladio.
Hey, come
that's
again.
That's about it. If you like to keep those accessories, most of them you can buy back later, but it's a cheap way to so we don't have to worry about the money situation right now. We're gonna go ahead and go to gear. We're gonna go ahead and go to Gladio. War sword goes to blade. We're gonna get the kite shield. Up his damage avengers or go to cutlass. We already have the drain lens, as you can see, so we don't have to worry about it. We gotta upgrade it in cactus. So it goes to calamity, which will end venom, which is really good. That's about it.
Excuse me.
The choke we said makes our birds nervous. And to prevent accidents.
That's the
tragedies.
Quest for the guy that will send you to go kill the behemoth. Rentals.
But hold on now. Ain't you lads the hunters that have been making a mark? You reckon you could handle the likes of Deadeye? If you could bring the beast down, there'd be a reward in it for you.
So before we embark, he doesn't automatically give you the quest to go kill that beast. What you have to do is talk to him.
What'll it be today?
We're going to have him reveal the local area.
Still keeping
and then
on,
we're
going to
go ahead and select Blind's Eye, the behemoth we're going to go kill.
Reckon I could ask for your help?
And he's the behemoth undertaking, so he's not that bad at all. And we also want to knock out this one, but we'll knock that out when we come back.
Best of luck to you. Good luck.
Okay, cool. So that's done. And I'm have pretty sure we have a good amount of potions.
What is it?
One thing I will do.
Howdy.
Add on another 10
there
potions. Two Phoenix down.
Thanks.
And that's all we need.
Come back soon.
Always buy a couple Phoenix downs here or there when I get a nice little plop of money, just so we always have them. You'll need it towards the end of the game. I think even at the end of the game I had a ton extra, but it never hurts to be safe. So you got your equalizer food buff still on. That's going to make this beginning of fight pretty straightforward and easy. And the next time we go to camp, we have an extra equalizer food that we can use after we go to camp, so that's fantastic. But we're going to try to get as much as we can done in this day before we actually have to camp and go to sleep.
Something's amiss. Come on.
So basically, after we get this day done and we end up at the camp, we're going to use the equalizer food again. So from the, we're going to craft it at camp, and then when we head out in the morning, then we'll be able to go immediately to the next quest as well. And that's going to work itself out pretty well. After that, then we'll do a bunch of the side quests to get our assassin daggers and some other stuff and get the extra money, top off our magic, and proceed to go fight Titan at that point.
Another one to wrap up quick.
So we're going to go ahead and go into Elemency. We got 9 casts of this. We got one more dual cast of this, so we're just going to go ahead and equip it, cast it real quick. And we still got plenty of magic for the year. There we go. So we're going to go back to Elemency. And equip. We got 9 casts of this, so that'll help out during the Behemoth. And that's it. Pretty straightforward. Double A pluses with the bristles, 2-2. Plus, there's a lot of nice, easy items you can get around here. Those are the monsters you want to fight around these area. That will make it so that you'll have a lot easier time. When you fight those monsters around here, they give those bristles, and those bristles make it so you can make double cast level 99 spells. So when we get to that one point when we farm them for a little bit, it'll be mostly to get some AP for the skills that we most definitely need. But most importantly, it will make it so that we'll have enough of a catalyst so we can push towards the end of the game and make sure most boss fights we have dual cast level 99 double cast spells or catalysts to up our damage on our spells.
Not.
That's Blind's Eye, really weak behemoth. He is feeling some type of way.
Deadeye, the name says it all. Let's move.
This is one of the moments that the game likes to go into Metal Gear mode, where it makes you stealth around when you don't really need to. But there's nothing you can really do against it.
we go. It's weak on the right. No eye, no horn.
We'll stay in range until we can exploit its blind spot. Exercise due caution.
We've got the beast in our sights.
But no plan of attack. The behemoth should be headed back to its lair, where we can catch it fully off guard.
Yeah, as long as we stay on guard ourselves.
Yeah, they got a lot of DLC planned out. Like, a lot of this shit should have been in the game already, but, you know, they gotta get their money. They were just talking about DLC, if you guys are wondering out there in YouTube land. Biggs, the homie, said they need to do at least two DLCs, one for Arena, one for Gladios, and four plan, he said, is good. So one for Gladios, one for Prompto, one for Ignis, and then, you know, whatever else they want to add in. Never did anything with the Arena, with the betting of the monsters and stuff like that, but it is pretty cool from what it seems. This behemoth needs to hurry up, though. He is taking his sweet time. Biggs is gonna cheat. You can cheese the monster arena by saving before the match and reloading if you lose. Biggs is gonna cheese the system. Biggs just wanna get paid. Alright, so that was it. Now we're gonna get through and whoop his ass. We still got the food buff on us. Overwhelm is gonna do ridiculous damage here in combination with the fact that we have the equalizer buff that makes it so that every level difference between us and our target does we do more damage, and since we're level 1 and he's level 15, that's gonna be great. We have some magic, So this fight's gonna go pretty well expected. We're gonna head back to camp after this, do a couple extra
haul in a day's work.
Hunts and get as much as we can done before this food buff expires, and then we'll go ahead and hit the do some other side quests, and then we'll go ahead and hit up the next dungeon and proceed onwards. Okay. Now, you can blow up these flame barrels to do more damage to Behemoth, but I wouldn't waste time. If you so happen to do this fight before you get the equalizer food, well, you might want to do that. That will definitely speed it up, but even in that situation, you could just slow beat the Behemoth and you'll have no problems. So here he comes, and we're just about to wail on him pretty horrendously. And he's letting us charge our tech meter up while he waits to get into battle, which is great. Drop the spell. Then we're going to go right into Overwhelm. Hopefully he doesn't act too crazy when we get to Overwhelm. And as you know, when you do Overwhelm, he can't damage you while you're doing it. And he hopped back up there. Now we have to wait for him to hop back down because he's being a jerk. Then we just go right back into battle. We're just basically waiting on the next overall game to come up, which it has, right back into Overwhelm. And you can see this is the reason why I told you guys to get it, and he's dead already, and we're only level 1. So the Overwhelm in combination with the Equalizer Food makes short work of him. He's dead already. We're going to go out the back way to run up a little bit, and then we're going to go ahead and warp back to the
There's four of us, just like in the game.
Well, then I got to be a 5-star character.
But,
yeah, Equalizer Food basically kind of turns a level 1 run into a joke. But, I mean, hey, if you really want to be crazy, you could not use that either. And the only thing that really happens is when you do all that... Oop, I think I went the wrong way. When you do that, it just basically makes you have to choose another way to kind of beat out the game, which would be basically you utilizing poison. So once we run out here, we should be able to teleport back to the car. You gotta run out a little bit of ways and around the corner, then it finally lets you warp back to the car. Of course, looking at where I'm at on the map, we are close to some fire and ice, so before we do that, we're going to grab them first, then teleport back since we're in the area, because you know me, I'm all about our magic, and magic's our friend. We always collect magic when we can, because we can make some powerful ass spells to blow some shit up. My main concern is I want to get in one more hunt. I want to get in one more hunt before the day gets a little bit too crazy. I might actually even do a nighttime hunt. We'll get a little bit more AP, a couple more items. Most importantly, the AP, the items, and like I said, you really want to utilize this buff when you have it, and we got a good amount of it left. There we go. So we're full on that one. We're full on lightning. We're going to use the bristles that we got in order to craft a lot of powerful magic. That's why I said it's so great that we fought a pack of those, and plus we picked up a lot of them, and with that item that increases the drop rate, we got a shit ton of them. So we go down to Elemency. We're going to put everything we have into this magic. We should be able to get two hunts done before the food buff wears off. Then we'll camp, do a lot of other side quests to get a shit ton of money, and then we'll proceed on to doing more of the storyline stuff. So, alright, so as you see, we got the Vortube Bristles. We want to use all 13, 7, dual cast, chain 89, potency 200, which is great. Alright, so we're going to store it. We're going to top off our magic, because we never not top off our magic. We never leave magic we can draw. We always get magic. Unless you're doing a no magic playthrough, which actually would be very interesting.
I'm just glad he's on our side.
It would definitely be annoying in certain situations, but I could see it being done. It wouldn't be that bad. You would just use Overwhelm and other stuff like that. Like, I think if you were to do no magic playthrough, like level 1 no magic playthrough would actually be very interesting. Also, level one playthrough, no equalizer food also would be good. So, we are going to return to the car. So, we're going to knock out a hunt, turn in this quest for killing that behemoth. Extra gold or gil is always a fantastic thing. There we go.
You boys did it. I give you my heart.
So, about the
high birds.
Cool.
Boy,
so, we got
really
that knocked out. 3,200 gil in the amethyst bracelet, which we could sell for money if we need to. Which is like another 1,000, so that's pretty good money.
Come on, Nox.
Takes about 3,400 to craft a one experience equalizer food. Okay, so we're gonna talk to our friend here.
So what'll it be today?
We are going
Grab
to go
some
down
grub
here.
Before you go. Leeson's been giving us a
we're
real
gonna go
hassle.
Ahead and knock out the Red Tooth and the Claw, and also the Exorcism one. But we're gonna do Red Tooth and Claw because those guys dropped the
choice.
Bristles, I do believe. We get 2,000 gil as well too.
Y'all take care now.
And we're actually gonna use the Chochibo for this, so we're just gonna go ahead and do one day. Chochibo is gonna pull up. There he is. Oh, we also wanna. There we go. That camera strap is pretty
Let's
much
go.
Useless. Unless you want to take pictures in battle, but that's an extra 1,000 gil we can sell that shit for. And you know, Debo, he's about his money.
You know how chocobos smell really bad? It's like a good kind of bad smell.
If you really feel that way, they could probably use you in the stables.
Alright.
Thanks for the ride.
Now, you don't have to cast magic here, but you know, Debo... magic just gets the shit done quick. And here we want to use Gladios' Tempest, because he can hit a lot of targets at once. I think you could actually end up picking up a Thunder Sword as well. Don't quote me on that, I didn't check the equipment guy before we left Lestalin.
Sorry.
One more AoE and they should most of them should be dead.
Hey, big guy.
Here comes Glad. But the main thing is we're getting the Boar Tooth Bristles. When we get the Beast Whistle, we'll come back here and hunt these guys for a bit to get some easy AP and stuff like that, because it does make a big difference. And we can round out and get the skills that we need. Target eliminated.
None the worse for
which is great. We got the 3
Bring
AP.
On the next one.
Which works out pretty well. It's getting closer to night. We're gonna go ahead and pop an antidote because I don't like that poison. You can pick up more at the shop if you need to, but you really don't need it anytime soon. Just when I happen to get poisoned, and that's like, you know, it does get a little bit annoying. So we're gonna turn this in, wait till nightfall, go kill the guys or the like the necromancer, those weird spell casting guys. We'll get some additional money. We'll go ahead and sleep. And call it a night. Actually, now that I'm looking at it, the quest that we have to do. So I'm trying to see here. Is way over here. So I do believe, if I'm not crazy, there is a campsite close by, but it won't really matter. We'll just use the campsite, teleport back to Lestalem, and then just go directly to the dungeon.
Today.
So that's knocked out.
Glad to see y'all made it back in one piece. Y'all still keeping on?
And this is the last
Reckon
one we're going to do since we're in the area. 3,000 gold and then a moon pendant, which we can sell and get more money.
Get her done.
He's going to ask you, do you want to wait till night? You want to hit yes. And we should have just enough food buff so we can go kill it.
Good luck.
Yeah, we do.
So when the ground shakes, your brain aches?
Yeah. Sort of seismic shock to the system.
So we're gonna go ahead and call up the Chochibo. We don't want to get in the car and do that. And I do believe right next to where we fight these guys is actually, it's pretty nice in a sense because there is a campsite there as well too. So we can actually camp and use the food there, teleport back to the car, teleport back to the stall, and then go from there. Get to these guys, we're basically just gonna drop magic and just beat them down. There's some of the demons at night, that's okay, we don't need to fight them, we just leave. But even though we could beat them, we have the equalizer food on, it wouldn't be that bad actually, but just, I would tell you not to waste time on that. Now they're trying to tell you it's gonna get late at night, we don't care, because that's the whole point, and we don't want to waste our food buff. 3,400 a craft is not cheap. You can fight these guys without equalizer food as long as you have assassin daggers, but I wouldn't advise it. Just use the equalizer foods after, you know, that's why we use it early. Kill behemoth, and then kill these, and get a lot of things done, and we're gonna camp and teleport back. But we're almost there. A couple magic attacks, a couple overwhelms, and a couple autos, they'll all be dead. Guys are being assholes already. Okay, now we're gonna go ahead and do overwhelm. And this is why I say overwhelm is so important, because it just really lets you just put one over on the enemies you fight. They are giving Noctis a little bit of a hard time. And then since we do have Noctis, or not Noctis, Pompa with that one weapon, he is poisoning him, which does 80% damage. And like I said, these guys are just giving me a hard time. Pushing out. And you know what? We're just gonna go ahead and overwhelm it. And it should die in one hit. And that's it. So we got 3 AP, then we got some nice items from him. We're gonna go ahead and pick up this item over here, and there is a camp nearby if I'm not crazy. Yeah, well, there's one there, one there, one there. So not one too nearby. But if we wanted to, we can camp out that one. Pick up the item here, it's the Fencer's Ankle, that's another one we could sell. So what we're gonna go ahead and do, let's go to map. We're gonna return the car. Sleep. Go to the camp. Get the magic. And rest there to get the food buff, and then go on from there. Okay then. So. Go ahead and turn it in and get our reward.
So what'll it be today? Boy, you really saved our hides.
And that's it. But like I said, the main reason why we killed those is because we had the food buff up.
Grab
and we didn't want to waste
before
it.
You go.
Because like I said, again, 7,000 gil, you want to get the most of your money's worth. Come over here, talk to our boy right here.
What can I do you for?
Behemoth horn we're going to keep. Crooked Helix horn we're going to sell.
There you are.
We're keeping the bristles because that's a good craft. The bull, the claw too, you could sell. It's up to you. Accessories, we're going to go ahead and sell the moon pendant, the fencer's anklet, and the camera strap. And that gives us a good amount of money. Okay, so now we're going to sleep to pass the time, go to the camp, eat the food, then go do the next dungeon. I'm going to check my magic real quick. We got 6, 7, that's more than enough to clear out the next dungeon. So, we're still going to have to stop by camp to camp real quick after we make it go to the morning, but that's okay, because there's magic by camps, and we love magic by camps, because we always want to top up our magic. Okay. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and go to auto. We're going to go to a map point. We are going to select the nearby campsite, draw our magic in the
ready for more? You bet.
And knock out the sword in the waterfall main quest. After that, then we're going to have to look into killing Ifrit, but that are not Ifrit, I'm sorry, Titan. That will put us into the next chapter. Chapter 4, you kill Titan, then you go into chapter 5. And then after chapter 5, I'm thinking about it right now. You have to actually get the pieces of Ramla and stuff like that, so. Actually, what we're going to do now that I think about it, well, no, it won't be bad at all. We'll be fine.
Where do we go from here?
What we're going to do is we're going to hit up this campsite, and this campsite. We're going to make sure we have enough magic. And then we'll proceed on to the next dungeon, because I remembered after you do that dungeon... And I'm trying to think, is that no, all that starts after the Titan fight, so we're fine. But I'm just thinking ahead for just making sure we have extra magic so we don't have to keep worrying about coming back here. Again. We'll just keep it moving for now. And we want to fight these guys over here because these guys drop awesome things. They drop the bristles. Oh, you know what? I just realized we don't have our food buff anymore. That's okay. We'll still be able to knock these guys out. Even if you don't have the food buff, these guys are very easy to take out. Alright, cool.
Oh yeah.
Alright, so before we actually do that, we're going to go ahead and pick up the assassin daggers. And then we also can pick up the metal that we need for Dino. And then we'll go to the next dungeon, because the assassin daggers are very nice because they add poison elemental damage to our attacks, which does big damage to the bosses. Don't worry, I know we're doing a lot of prep work, but trust me, as soon as we get all this basic stuff done, the rest of the game is going to fly by and you're going to look up and be like, man, that actually went real quick, Debo wasn't lying. So we're going to go to quest location, and we are going to go to Dino's. It's a 3-minute drive. I will be right back.
You always set
gonna grab
sweeties.
Me a couple cookies.
Never realized you were selling to chocobos.
I'm totally into chocobos. Don't take that the wrong way.
There's no wrong way to love a chocobo.
Do we have to walk?
Now, I wouldn't say the assassin daggers are mandatory, but anybody wants to take it, it makes the game a lot easier. A lot more straightforward.
Yeah, you guys better take this one.
We're gonna leave those level 20 monsters on. They don't drop anything particularly.
Let the gem hunt begin!
You'll be hunting a long time. Only raw stones around here.
Now, do you really need to finish this and go back to your boy? Not really. But that's up to you. You can just pick up the gems, bring it back to him, and go from there.
Oh, this is it? Man, ore is a real bore.
You can pick up the assassin daggers and bounce, but I think I'm going to finish this quest. Because I think I do remember I did use the amulet he gives me later on in the run. First segment in which I want to do more damage. So there's the assassin daggers. We're going to go ahead and hit this, go to gear. Take out the Axe of the Conqueror. For the assassin's daggers. So now when you're attacking, you should be using assassin's daggers always to inflict the poison and go from there. Now let me see here. There it is.
Alright. Just one more stone to go.
I don't think you can poison this one because this enemy is poisonous. When you do poison a target, they'll start growing green. You can't overwhelm it.
Now's our chance.
Hey, where'd you learn that one?
And we just killed it because I do believe one of the points here to pick up the Helidor stones or
yeah, can't stand them.
Is around here. Icky. We already got the one far over here. It's somewhere close in here. For the last gym that we need. I'm pretty sure we got this one over here, because that one's just sticking out like a Thor's sword thumb, which I did. But there is one more. We did get the one by the water. I think that's one over there. I'm just going crazy. It's got to be right around here somewhere. I imagine it's probably most definitely on one of these outer rocks. Maybe right along over here. You figure by the fourth time I played through this game I would remember, but I usually just always stumble around, collect them all, then forget about the placements and moves on. I do remember the assassin's dagger every time. So we got that one there. Let me see here. There should be one more. Somewhere in the middle here. I think that was the same one I originally got, this one. So, that means probably one of these stocks. There it is. And that should be the last one. And that's it.
1, 2, 3. That'll do it. Now let's head back.
Alright, so turn to the car. right. We're just going to go ahead and just go see Dino right now. So we're going to go ahead and do auto, map point, and then you know where our boy Dino's at. We can also pick up the magic there and stock up with some extra magic. Then we'll camp out, teleport to Balot back to Lestalem, do the next dungeon, and then we'll move on to Titan. And that's pretty much about it. Once we get the Beast Whistle, we'll do some last little bits of farming, knock out the additional quests that give us a lot of gil, and then keep it moving.
Here we are.
We made it.
Okay. We're gonna visit Mr. Dino, teleport back to the car, hit the beach over there, camp, get the magic, instant teleport back to Lestalem, drive over and do the quest. There's some crabs outside, some nice items we can get inside there, but we're just gonna breeze right through that whole dungeon. Come back to Lestalem, close it out, talk to Arjun. And then we're going to be doing the Titan quest. All of it's pretty straightforward.
Welcome to Golden Key.
Bet those
they put up a
well here. Well, that baby right there is unlike anything you've seen before. Drop by again sometime and let me know what you think.
And that's the last time we're gonna see this guy. We got everything we need out of him. You use the Helidor bracelet or you can sell it. It's up to you. Okay, back to the car.
Scoops he's got.
All right.
About those stones.
We're gonna go ahead and hit the beach over here because there's magic there.
Camp.
Let's call it a day.
And remember, we already bought one Midgar Solemn Steak, the one Nutmeg, and the Killer Tomato, so we can make one of the food that the Equalizer food, and we're going to teleport back to Lestalem after this and do the next quest. And there it is. If you didn't remember to buy it, then you can just go back to Lestalem, buy the ingredients, and use it to do the next adventure. Or if you just want to blow your money, you always can just buy the $7,000 one from the restaurant vendor, but I wouldn't recommend that. And we do have a couple points into increase the longevity or extend the time, how long that buff stays. So my food buff will be a little bit longer. I advise even just getting the first level one. You can even get the second one for 99 AP. But you definitely want to put at least the initial extend the base time of it, because it does make a big difference. So we got all our magic. We're just going to go ahead and craft some right now. We got a lot of good magic, but like I said, we want to stock up. I usually try to keep everything pretty much full out of all my little flasks of magic. Alright, now we just got to pick a catalyst. Ooh, rare tooth bristles. We got a bunch of those. Sounds like a great idea. 7 of 2 chain 89. Fantastic. And we're just going to store that. Go back to the car. And then after we get the car, when we get back to the car, we're going to go up to 99 potions. Buy about 5 Phoenix Downs. Maybe an antidote, but I mean, you really don't need to antidote, but you know. But we definitely have more than enough money to max out our potions. Three Phoenix Downs. And then what we're going to do outside of that, I think we're going to buy 5 antidotes. Okay. Regalia, auto, map point. We're going to go to Lestalem. There we go. Fast travel there.
Once we get there, then we're going to go right back in Regalia, take the quest right over to the dungeon, knock out that dungeon, come back. And then after we come back, we'll have enough money to buy one more,
or I think 2 sets. We'll have enough to buy 2 sets of the equalizer food. Then we're going to go right away into Titan. And then once we finish Titan, I'm trying to think here. Then we got the Ramua quest. And then after that, we have to infiltrate the base. So we might need 3. I don't know. We'll see. We'll suck up. We need at least 3 of the food buff if we want to get through Titan, the next set of dungeons after that. And then right before we move onward past chapter 5, or basically when we leave Lestalem with Iris, when we start making our way to Altessa, we're going to need to do all the photographer quests, because that's going to give us another big ton of money. And we want all that money, because that will make it so we don't have to worry about buying or doing anything for a good long time.
So what's next? Ask around a little.
But one thing we will do, if we return and we have a bunch of time left, we are going to do some hunts. Because like I said, if you ever have equalizer food on, don't try to waste your day. Unless you have so much money and you're good to go and you just want to power through the rest of the game. So when we come back, we will do some hunts. Just because it's very easy to get some extra money. So we have how much money? We have 10k, which means we can buy about 3, but we can't really.
Hello there. What do you need today?
So what we'll do? Well, we'll just buy 3 killer tomatoes.
Thanks. Right. Thanks here. For choosing Falstar.
We'll pick up the other food items as well, and then we'll do the hunts after that quest. Actually, the way I'm thinking about it right now, there's a setup so I can do a quest and knock out that dungeon at the same time.
So many stalls here.
Okay, so we're gonna go over here. We're gonna pick the extra supplies for our food equalizer. Tantalizing.
I'm detecting a rather unique blend of spices.
Your nose knows everything.
You don't want the quest.
Hey, brother. You're a hunter, right?
Yeah.
Well, the vehicle.
Oh my goodness, buddy. I just want to buy your food wares.
Burning up in here.
Hey, brother.
There we go.
What are you after this time?
I want to buy 3 of these.
Pleasure doing business.
And then we need 3 nutmegs. We could sell Behemoth Horn. We could sell. We get plenty of those later. But we're actually going to go ahead and chill out with selling anything right now. So we got all that stuff. We're going to go talk to the food vendor guy over here. Because then he can give us a hunt that's in the area that we're going to go to anyways. So that when we come back after doing the dungeon, we'll have the hunt money waiting for us. We'll have finished the dungeon, and then we can hit another hunt up. In chapter 3. then proceed onwards to chapter 4.
Welcome. Some refreshments.
So go ahead and reveal some of the area for us. Good. Alright, cool. Okay, cool. Awesome.
Can we rely on you?
Let me see here. You know what? I think we're just going to have to come back and wait. Because I remember one of them only happens at nighttime. Which we could do that. Make it nighttime and go there. But I think it's better we knock the quest out first and then we'll do that. So we got our equalizer buff on. We should be able to clear this dungeon, have some time so we can do one hunt.
Check it out.
And get some extra money. Okay, so auto, and then we're gonna go ahead and do quest location, and it's a waterfall.
Folk here are real friendly.
Yeah, everybody greets you. Takes some getting used to.
You draw more attention here than you do at home.
Felt a few drops. Watch your heads.
Okay, we're here finally. We have been driving a little bit. We should probably fill up the tank right now. We have a chance to, since it's right here. Okay, onward to the next dungeon. It's a very easy dungeon. It's not that difficult. We have plenty of magic to deal with the certain points in which it does get a little bit crazy. And we're at but right now we're at 4 hours into the game, which is not that bad. There is like a, I like to call it the Midgar Zalem. It's a throwback to the monster from Final Fantasy VII. Down here, you can fight him with the equalizer food. I wouldn't recommend it. Just leave him be and then just keep moving on, because the only thing he really will give you is like his food drop, which you use to make the material. As you can see, there he is. I would just ignore him. You don't even have to deal with him. Oh. Oh. I'm getting stuck on everything. There we go.
Enemy on your left.
Got it.
No duh. We got some crabs coming up here.
Ready for this? See ya! See ya!
Gladio!
I've come up with a new recipe.
I could taste test for you.
I don't know why it strikes a pose and shows us. We should just look it up inside the recipe box after we're done. There's one item behind here. And keep it moving. Mega Phoenix is coming very handy towards the end of the game. Makes your life a lot easier. Oop. I have to go back up this way.
Says to look behind the waterfall.
What does the waterfall say?
I think it says, come in. Wouldn't you know it? An entrance.
Looks like the legend.
This place gives me goosebumps. So, well, looking on the bright side, maybe the cold keeps the demons at bay?
Because monsters like warmth.
Ah, sarcasm. Hmm. But what if they're frozen?
Encased.
And there's our warm water.
No use hanging around here.
Heading down a
and down we go.
Say your prayers. Let's get it over with.
Cool deal.
So much for a little chill. Oh, I got an ice cream headache. Without the ice cream. Come here for nothing.
Again.
Really?
And the carbon bangle right there.
Yeah.
Nothing to it.
And we always get magic whenever we have a chance to. And we're just gonna keep it moving.
Watch your step.
No more slip-ups.
On we go.
Indeed.
Right. Nothing turned up.
Did you double check?
Triple checked.
Then we're done.
Where to next?
Thing.
Phoenix down, well worth it. Cool. 1,000 gold save, or I'm sorry, not gold, a gill.
I did not see that coming.
Say your prayers.
We'll be alright. Sorry.
Okay, that's
it. Knocked, if I may.
Don't ask.
Yep, we're lost.
Don't answer. Don't know where we came from? Don't know where we're going.
Push towards the end of the dungeon and get back in town.
Yep.
If I could figure out how to get backed up, I think I got turned around a little bit.
This one's just for you.
My hand slipped.
A couple extra fights are not that bad. We'll give us the additional AP that we need.
The glaive is through here.
Most likely.
There we go.
Let's see for ourselves.
A little bit more magic. We don't want to fall off from up here. But we want an easy item if we can get it. Then we have to go across a narrow ledge gap. And then it's towards the area.
Again? Excuse me.
Getting by.
And Ignis is down. I really don't want to waste the Phoenix down. Okay, cool.
That was a close one.
Too close for comfort.
I'm comfortable just being alive.
Just gotta be careful I don't slip here. Let me come around the way.
My name's Mo.
We're catching cold.
So here we go.
There we go.
I'm freezing. Oh, what I wouldn't give for a hot bowl of soup. Soup. We're almost there. We gotta be. Right?
Hey.
And that's all she wrote, and that's it for the dungeon. Like I said, as long as you have a little equalizer food, very straightforward dungeon, nothing too hard about it all.
Yep.
And we got 59
Does
AP points.
Can go back outside?
I think we're gonna go ahead and just bank it up to 99 and extend the food buff one more time. Right. Don't like how fast it went out. And I do believe we need 99 for the next level, which is over here in exploration. Yeah, 99. So we'll just wait until we get 99 and get that, and then we'll move into magic. Okay. We can go ahead and skip this cutscene. And okay. And that's it. And that's where we turn us back to the front entrance.
And we should be able to go directly back to town, and then that will end the chapter.
Noctis has another headache.
Let's make our way back to Lestalem.
Yeah, gotta report to Talcott.
Map. Return to car. I don't know if they'll let us fast travel back to the main city. If not, we'll just simply sleep at the house right there. Just like a little inn, a place where you can sleep at. I don't think they'll let us fast travel. We'll see. Auto, map point. Oh, looks like we will be able to fast travel back to Lestalem. Great. So we're making some pretty decent time. At least in my opinion, I think we're doing okay. We probably should be able to get the game completed within 15 hours for the level 1 walkthrough. Which is not bad, considering. You do have to do a little bit of prep work here and there, though. Because money is a major thing you definitely need during this run. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and turn this quest, and then we'll go and talk to Arden, and that will go ahead and start us for the next area.
They ought to keep the demons at bay.
Not...
Yeah, we can't skip this segment.
Welcome back.
Your story came to a happy end.
Well, well.
We owe you, Talcott.
You're welcome.
We owe you, Talcott.
You're welcome.
Okay. So that's pretty much about it. We're gonna head to the outlet. We're gonna talk to Adrian, and we're gonna facilitate ending this chapter. We're gonna go ahead and take a little bit of pause on the stream. I'm gonna get these files uploaded and everything set correctly, and then I will be back a little bit later, a couple hours from now. We'll knock out chapters. We're gonna knock out chapter 4, of course, and probably also chapter 5 and 6, and possibly 7 today too.
I'm not one to stand on ceremony, but such an occasion calls for an introduction. Please call me Arden. Come with me to the car park. That's where I left my automobile. She's a dear old thing. Pales next to your regalia, but she's never let me down. So, we take two vehicles, a convoy of sorts, shall we?
Okay.
All set. Allow me to do the honor of assigning your driver. I choose you.
Fine by me.
You drive your car and I drive mine. With that decided, let us be off.
And we'll go ahead and stop right here since it's the end of chapter. When we come back, we're going to do some side quests from our friend, the photographer who gives us a lot of money, Knockout Titan. That'll complete that chapter. Then we'll move into the next chapter of that, which will be 5, which will be doing the Rama side quest and getting back the regalia for the level 1 playthrough. I'll see you guys back a couple more hours from now. If you're on YouTube video out there, then of course you'll be going on to the next video. So I'll see you guys then.